megastars, the millionaires, the masterminds. Seriously wealthy, glamorous, and influential. They are the rich and famous. If you have to ask how much, then you can't afford them. They have staff. Even their staff have staff. They are the superstars. Kate Blanchett, the girl's got something. Something magical, something human, something regal. A rare mix of fragility and steely will. Critics can't define it, directors can't measure it, but the producers have had to. If they want the pale Australian, they'll have to put their hands down deep in their pockets. The lady asks over $13 million a film and rising with each prestigious acting award. Every time this girl leaves a film set, the industry is ready to hand her another acting award, making it increasingly hard to get through those airport metal detectors on the way home to Sydney. Her first high-profile role was as Elizabeth I of England in the 1998 movie Elizabeth, which won her an Academy Award nomination for Best Actress. Blanchett lost out to that other Elizabethan player, Gwyneth Paltrow, for Shakespeare in Love, but won a British Academy Award and a Golden Globe for Best Actress in a Motion Picture Drama. The following year, Blanchett was nominated for another BAFTA Award for her supporting role in The Talented Mr. Ripley. And in 2005, she won an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actress for playing Katharine Hepburn in Martin Scorsese's The Aviator. So that's the first actress to get an Oscar for playing another Oscar-winning actress. Maybe there's an award for that. For some audiences, Blanchett was still flying around the fringes until she appeared in Peter Jackson's blockbuster, The Lord of the Rings movies. As the High Elf Queen Galadriel, she captured the imagination of every girl who privately fancied herself as a fairy queen. The three films of the fantasy epic hold the record as the highest grossing film trilogy of all time. Awards mean influence. In fact, Blanchett was named as one of Time magazine's 100 most influential people in the world in 2007. Kate Blanchett's future projects read like a who's who of Hollywood, including top directors' names like Spielberg and Scorsese. So this little Red Riding Hood can be assured of keeping the wolf from her door for quite a long while to come, especially with the baskets of goodies Kate can get from personal endorsements. Even Blanchett, known for her reluctance to play the celebrity game, has warmed to the idea of cashing in on her fame. Long known for her flawless complexion, the actress says it's due to her ongoing use of luxury skincare product SK11. Well, she has to say that because she's been named the cosmetics global ambassador. And it's working. The Blanchett-backed SK11 is a boon to the burgeoning Australian skincare market. Sales of the product have grown over $800 million in Australia alone. The actress also endorses the Donna Karan designer collection worldwide. At first, she was reluctant to become an advertising icon, but she admits coming off a sweaty film set, she's now ready to get her hair and lippy done and take some photos in Rome. Hey, where do I sign up for that? I could look this good in a $10,000 Donna Karan evening gown. Blanchett describes herself as part extrovert, part wallflower. The way the lady is going, I'd add part superstar to that. Cameron Diaz. If it looks like a superstar, lives like a superstar, and pulls in a whopping $20 million a film, it probably is a superstar. Cameron Diaz has serious pulling power. There's a major attraction between the star and the global audience. The Diaz dial on a movie poster means box office. Big box office. The actress now has a net worth of $75 million. She's always had the X factor with the Cuban name and those long European legs. At 16, she was signed with top modelling agency Elite Management. And modelling took her around the world, working for designers like Calvin Klein and Levi's. Then she became an accidental actress, seeming to fall into a profession that was happy to catch her. Diaz got her big break in 1994 as an unknown, starring opposite Jim Carrey in The Mask. Then the actress stroke model started to gain mainstream success with her roles in My Best Friend's Wedding and There's Something About Mary. She won critical acclaim for her performance in Being John Malkovich, which earned her Best Supporting Actress nominations at the Golden Globes, the BAFTA Awards and the Screen Actors Guild Awards. Proving she can cut it with the major male stars, Diaz is one of three actresses to join the coveted $20 million club after receiving this salary for the smash Charlie's Angels. Having proved her status as one of the film industry's top earners, Cameron Diaz pulled in a healthy eight digits for each performance behind the microphone in the hit series Shrek. So, what does she do with all that lovely money? Cameron Diaz is a self-proclaimed poker fanatic and plays in tournaments on a regular basis. On hearing this, Betcris online casinos wasted no time offering the beauty a $1.5 million endorsement. Unfortunately, she declined, or should I say, she folded. But those pesky high principles can get in the way of serious revenue raising. And Cameron Diaz knows better than anyone that celebrity sells, especially in Japan, a nation of devoted Hollywood fans. Let's face it, fame can be fleeting, and it's a good idea to maximise your earnings while you're still hot. Cameron Diaz can get $1 million to $5 million from a single overseas ad campaign. So does that affect the celebrity's marquee value back home? Not anymore. The conventional wisdom of ads as credibility killers is fading. Appearing in far-flung campaigns actually helps Cameron Diaz sell more movie tickets worldwide. Cameron received a huge chunk of change to appear in a series of ads for a chain of English language schools in Japan, which is kind of ironic. When Diaz was asked if she could speak her Cuban father's language, Spanish, she replied, "Are you kidding? I can barely speak English properly." Diaz also endorses Japanese mobile phone company SoftBank. She earned herself a cool $3 million for appearing in one SoftBank commercial. The commercial shoot took only 6 hours of her time, which works out to a nice little payday of $8,000 a minute. Well, it is true then. The ancient Japanese proverb, "If you look this good on the red carpet, someone's bound to give you a cell phone contract." And there's another famous Japanese saying, "Making money is hard, losing it on the poker table is easy." Remember that one, Cameron. Brad Pitt, named the sexiest man alive several times over. He is arguably the most famous actor in Hollywood. He stands at the very top of the A-list, and you can see the whole world from there. Brad Pitt is a superstar with a net worth of over $150 million. Sometimes it's hard to remember that Brad Pitt is a working actor and not just a media commodity for tabloid entertainment. It all started with a little role as a small-time criminal drifter in Thelma and Louise. And when the world copped an eyeful of Pitt in a love scene with Gina Davis, the world asked, who is that guy? But it's not just Brad Pitt's good looks that earn him upwards of $35 million a year. The guy can actually act. Pitt was nominated for an Academy Award and won a Golden Globe Award for his role in 12 Monkeys. Pitt's ascension to the A-list came in the 2000s with films like Ocean's 11, alongside other A-listers George Clooney and Matt Damon. The guys were now part of a Rat Pack with an enviable lifestyle. Then came Ocean's 12 and the epic Troy, portraying ancient superstar Achilles. But what transformed his life forever came in 2005. Pitt starred with Angelina Jolie in Mr. and Mrs. Smith. They played husband and wife assassins. And it was the beginning of the world's most famous couple. Public interest in the pair is insatiable. Paparazzi photos of Jolie and Pitt are sold for more than $500,000. People magazine paid more than $4.1 million for the rights to photos of the couple's first biological child, while British magazine Hello obtained the international rights for roughly $3.5 million. The total rights sale earned the couple up to $10 million worldwide, the most expensive celebrity image of all time. Still, through all the madness, Brad Pitt makes films, good ones. The actor put on a star turn in the critically acclaimed Babel, starring alongside Cate Blanchett. The movie garnered a total of 7 Academy Award and Golden Globe nominations. Pitt himself was nominated. The movie has since become Pitt's highest grossing drama, and what really puts the smile on his face, he was one of the producers. Pitt's production company, Plan B, has been quietly producing hits like Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Scorsese's The Departed, and his own star vehicle, The Assassination of Jesse James by the coward Robert Ford. So, will he also follow mate George Clooney into directing? No, Pitt says, it takes up too much of your time. And that's time he wants to spend with his partner and 4 children, either in their $100,000 a month New York pad with 6,000 square feet for the kids to run amok in, or their man-made island in the shape of Ethiopia off the coast of Dubai. The couple's purchase is part of a cluster of 300 islands shaped like a world map that is gradually surfacing in the waters off Dubai. Prices for the islands range from $6 million to $36 million. Brad Pitt is a rare entity in today's celebrity-obsessed culture. He's the subject of endless fascination and yet has managed to maintain an air of mystery. The question remains, will we ever get enough of Brad Pitt? I know I won't. Adriana Lima, the Brazilian supermodel, has been called the hottest girl on the planet, and she's the 4th richest model in the world. One biography has her extraordinary good looks as a result of her African, Indian, and Swiss descent. Another source has her heritage as French, Portuguese, Native American, and Caribbean. Well, whatever they put in that melting pot, it worked, and she's gonna milk it, Pouting her way to the top at a tune of $5 million a year. It's hard to believe that the model, born in 1981 when the world was listening to Duran Duran, has already landed some major contracts. Still, it shouldn't be so surprising. After all, the catwalks have been experiencing an incredible Brazilian invasion of models like Gisele Bündchen and Alessandra Ambrosio. 3 years after taking second place at the Ford Supermodel of the World contest in Brazil at the tender age of 13, Adriana decided to move to the Big Apple to see if she could conquer the modelling world. And it wasn't hard for the exotic beauty. She signed on as an elite model, and soon enough she was gracing covers of magazines like Vogue, Marie Claire and Harper's Bazaar. As for fashion shows, she has walked the catwalks for big name designers such as Vera Wang, Christian Lacroix, Fendi, Ralph Lauren and Valentino. With high profile campaigns for companies like Guess, Armani, Anna Sui Jeans, Bebe and Mossimo, it wasn't long before Lima's face and fabulous figure were plastered on billboards and in print ads. Her April 2006 GQ cover was the highest selling issue of the year. But no campaign would bring her to the recognition she received as a Victoria's Secret model and Maybelline spokesmodel. Adriana Lima is one of Victoria's Secret's perfect 10 models and one of Victoria's favourite angels. Lima appears in the controversial television ad for the brand alongside the legendary rock musician Bob Dylan. Critics thought the rock legend looked a little out of place in the lingerie commercial, but agreed that Adriana Lima was well cast indeed. I'm sick of love. Lima, with her exotic blue-grey eyes, was chosen as the most desirable woman by AskMen.com, leaving behind such stars as Angelina Jolie at number 9, Halle Berry at number 10, and Charlize Theron at number 3. Still, it can be lonely at the top. She says modelling is a tough job. Your co-workers are your rivals. It really puts a dampener on your perspective of other girls. And the young model regularly works a long way from her native Brazil, Paris, Milan and New York. Still, her worldwide travels are great excuses to shop. And she admits she's not very patient. I like everything now. I want it all now. Among the model's three significant long-term and very lucrative contracts is her endorsement for Telecom Italia, Italy's mega cell phone carrier. In fact, Lima is known as the Catherine Zeta-Jones of Italy, not for her acting skills, but for being the beautiful face of Italy's own cell phones. The impossible beauty says she never works out, and when asked if she was all, natural, she replied, tongue firmly in cheek, "No, it's all fake. From my hair to my toes to my nails, everything's fake. Everything, even my heart is fake." Well, I don't know. Maybe she was born with it. Maybe it's Maybelline. But whatever it is, it's made Adriana Lima a superstar. Nicole Kidman. She's the Oscar-winning actress. The elegant Australian who hits the ceiling at nearly 5'11". She is one of the highest paid actresses in the film industry. And once asked, what's the point of doing something good if nobody's watching? Don't worry, Nicole, everybody's watching. She's paid almost $18 million a film, and that's an exclusive club for only a handful of Hollywood beauties. The Australian has a net worth of $155 million, and that's an exclusive club for Australians. Well, she didn't get it sitting on those long white hands. Her breakthrough performance in 1995's satirical comedy To Die For earned her praise from critics and a record 6 acting awards, including a Golden Globe Award. Then, married to Tom Cruise, Hollywood had to concede. She was more than just Tom's handbag. Kidman and Cruise went on to portray a married couple in the much-anticipated Eyes Wide Shut in 1999, Stanley Kubrick's last film. It was the kind of kudos Kidman needed. But when the star divorced Tom Cruise, the public wondered, would she lose some of her fledgling star power? Even the actress herself had doubts. She said, "I dealt with the idea of never ever working again, never able to be an actress, and I was ready to give it all up when everything exploded." Exploded is right. In 2002, Kidman received an Academy Award nomination for her performance in the 2001 musical film Moulin Rouge, in which she played the courtesan Satine opposite Ewan McGregor. Consequently, Kidman received her second Golden Globe Award for Best Actress in a Motion Picture Musical or Comedy. The same year, she had a well-received starring role in the horror film The Others. In 2003, the star had three films released in weeks of each other, Cold Mountain, The Human Stain, and Dogville. Then, the ultimate reward. Kidman won an Academy Award for Best Actress for her portrayal of Virginia Woolf in The Hours, making her the first Australian actress to win an Oscar. Far from fading after her high-profile divorce, Kidman's stardom grew. In fact, Hollywood had a new superstar on its hands. And you can find some excellent company up there in the A-list. There were four Oscar winners at Kidman's wedding to second husband country music star Keith Urban: Russell Crowe, Jane Campion, Catherine Martin, and of course Kidman herself. Though the actress admits, if you talk about a box office career, then I'm a bit of a disaster. Yet she has enough X factor to stay on top, and that includes attracting some lucrative endorsements. Kidman is the face of the Chanel No. 5 perfume. And while shooting a 3-minute commercial for the fragrance, directed by Moulin Rouge director Baz Luhrmann, Kidman broke the record for the most money paid per minute to an actor: $928,800 per minute, a total of $3.71 million. Among her many residences, Kidman likes living in Nashville, the industry centre for Keith Urban's successful music career. And why wouldn't she like it? The $2.5 million home has 10 bedrooms, a pool, gym, and spa. Nicole Kidman sometimes worries, she says. "I'm always scared that one day I'll look back and say, God, they were the best years of my life, and now what? I'm scared it won't last." I say, take it easy, Nick, and have another spa.